because someone's been there already in the whole story. My sister Jane is president of this company. So that was in England. And she met the Beatles because she was invited by a magazine to go down and see their first appearance ever in London. The magazine wanted her to write a piece about what was all the fuss about. You know, she was, as I say, kind of a celebrity guest reviewer. So she went to see the band, thought they were terrific, and so of course you can hear it over there screaming, and thought they were amazing. She was taken backstage to meet them all at the end. One of them liked her in particular. You know, she liked them very much. So the Beatles were amazing. She liked them, they liked her, and one of them liked her in particular, and that was Paul, and that's how they ended up going out together for a number of years. And one of the results of that was that Paul, of course, was hanging around our house a great deal. You know, he would come over for dinner a lot, you know, he would bring his laundry for our mum to dinner, so that's what boyfriends do. And eventually our parents evidently sort of took pity on him because they offered him the guest room on the top floor of the house, which he accepted and moved into. So my bedroom was on the top floor, the guest room was next door, so two of us shared the top floor of the house for about 2 years. And during that time, of course, I did get to hear quite a number of songs, some in progress, some finished, some legendary songs, and there's many stories there. But in this particular case, I'd heard this song, Well Without Love, and told Paul I liked it. And he said, well, I haven't finished it. It's not finished. And John doesn't like it, so we're not doing it. Apparently, John specifically disliked the opening lyric. He thought that Please Lock Me Away was a ridiculous way to start a song. When Paul tried to play it to him, he would let Paul get as far as that Please Lock Me Away line, and then say to Paul, okay, I will, the song's over. So clearly the Beatles weren't going to cover it. No, we're still. So when Gordon and I got a record deal, which we got just by being spotted by an A&R guy for EMI, we signed a record deal, and they were looking for songs for our first day in the studio. We expected to do 4 or 5 songs. Our producer had picked several songs from our existing live show. This was just us being a couple of folkies with guitars playing in pubs and clubs. But he also said, do you know any other good songs that you might like to bring to the session? Maybe even some new songs. And I went, you know what? I think I know just one such song. So I went back to Paul and said, did you ever do anything with Well Without Love? Did you give it to anybody? Has John changed his mind? Have you finished it? And Paul said, no, and no, and no. I haven't finished it, and no one's doing it. I said, well, we've just got a record deal. Can we have it? Have we covered it? And he said, yes. He made a little demo for me. He wrote out the lyrics for me on a piece of paper that I still have safely locked away in my fireproof safe back home in Malibu. So that when the music business goes completely to shit, I can run to Sotheby's as fast as I make it. Paul can save the day. Anyway, hasn't got to that point yet. But anyway, so we worked out the song, we loved it, and we recorded it. And it went to number one in England first, number one in, believe it or not, 33 countries or something like that, all over the world. Finally, including being number one in America, changed my life forever. So we owe this song, I owe this song, a great debt of gratitude. So we're gonna end with that. It also makes a really good sing-along. Now, I know you may be thinking, well, you know, we'll never remember the words to something from that long ago. And I accept the fact that, given the fact that this record was number one, God help us, 60 years ago, that means that automatically, anyone who is old enough to remember when it was number one is probably automatically too old to remember any of the words. just like me up here, we're too old to remember much of anything. But you never know. You may find that when you hear the melody, I'm always amazed, a lot of people, the words come floating back to you through the mists of time, and you all join in and sing, which makes for a great ending to the show. So I'd like to thank you so much for coming, and hope and pray that none of us ever have to live in a world without love. 2, 3, 4.
Please lock me away, and don't allow where I hide with my loneliness. I don't care what they say, I will stay in a world without love. with my loneliness. I don't care what they say, I won't stay in a world without love and a rich and finding a horse. So I wait, and in a while I will see my true love smile. She may come, I know not when. When she does, I know. So baby, until then, love me away. And don't allow the day here inside where I hide with my loneliness. I don't care what they say, I won't stay in a world.
They say I won't stay.